Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and welcome to Station 4. And we are going to actually spend two stations talking about a superior view of the base of the cranium, or the basicranium. And there's a lot going on in this region, and I like to start with the most fun, which is the sphenoid bone. And the sphenoid bone has a whole lot of fun going on. And what we're going to focus on is really mostly openings that allow for neurovasculature to traverse, and we will have one fossa. So let's start anteriorly, and we'll make our way posteriorly and just kind of get an outline or a basic outline of where the sphenoid bone is located here. You can see it, this nice butterfly-shaped bone that's going to be in this region. You have these lesser wings and the greater wings, and then you can see all of these holes right here. So we're going to start with the optic canals. So these are the openings for the optic canals, and then the optic canal will, as its name would suggest, have something to do with the optic, or in terms of vision, so it is heading towards the orbit. The optic canals will allow cranial nerve, nerves to traverse to get to the orbit, or away from the globe to head back to the brain, and then as well as the ophthalmic arteries. And then just posterior to that, you'll see this fossa right here. It's almost kind of like the seat of the saddle. This whole area is called the Celaturcica, which means Turkish saddle. So that seat of the saddle is the hypophyseal fossa. And it is in the hypophyseal fossa that you are going to have the pituitary gland, or the hypophysis, sitting there. So very well protected in terms of this region right here. Okay, now let's move to the foramina or fissures that I think go right in order, and they also help me understand how the divisions of the trigeminal nerve will exit. And the first is going to be the superior orbital fissure. It is by far the most difficult to locate. It's just underneath or inferior to the lesser wings, but you can see a little bit of the superior right here. The superior orbital fissure is considerably larger than the rest of these foramina, and that has everything to do with the fact that there is more going through this fissure. And it's actually going to enter into the orbit region. So everything that's traversing this region has something to do or some form of communication with the orbit. So this will include cranial nerves 3, or the oculomotor, which are going to serve 4 out of the 6 extraocular eye muscles. It will also serve 4, cranial nerve 4, and cranial nerve 6. So all these three right here are going to serve those extraocular eye muscles. Also, V1, or the first division of the trigeminal nerve, will also traverse the superior orbital fissure, which is your ophthalmic division. So it makes sense that it's going to be in that region. Next, you have the roundest of our foramina, which is the foramen or foramina rotundum. And this is going to allow for exit of V2, or the maxillary division of the trigeminal nerve. And then the oval shaped foramen, which is going to be posterior to the rotundum, will be the foramen ovale, which allows for the exit of V3, or the mandibular division of the trigeminal nerve. And just next to the foramen ovale, kind of posterior lateral to the foramen ovale, is going to be the little bitty foramen spinosum, which allows for the middle meningeal artery, which is a branch of the maxillary artery, which is a branch of the external carotid artery, to enter into this region. And as it's the name would suggest, middle meningeal artery is going to supply the meninges. So that is going to be one of the major suppliers of the meninges. Okay, so that is what we're going through for this particular video. So the focus was on the sphenoid bone, and our next video we'll be looking at the same view, but we're going to talk more about the different fossae and then a few of the other foramina that we didn't touch on here. All right, you know I love the sphenoid. As always, as you work through these, please reach out with any questions, and thank you for your time and attention.